Hi everyone, I'm Any New Province, and this week we're going to find out if Llanowar Druid is possibly Pauper playable. This week we're taking a break from newly released commons in an attempt to go infinite. Llanowar Druid can untap all of your forest, and it even puts itself in your graveyard for recursion. That's why this week we're playing a deck called Grim Memory. As always, you can find the full deck list in the description down below. While you're down there, if you wouldn't mind liking the video and subscribing to the channel, I'd seriously appreciate it. It's a great way to let me know you've enjoyed everything, and it really encourages me to keep making great Pauper content. All right, let's have a look at Grim Memory. Llanowar Druid costs 1 and a green for a 1/2, and it says tap and sacrifice Llanowar Druid to untap all forests. This creature is an interesting piece of ramp, but doesn't do enough on its own to warrant a playset. Another one of our combo pieces, Fleet Feather Sandals, is also pretty anemic when it's drawn outside of the context of the combo, but we need them both to eventually go infinite. Our last combo piece can stand on its own, however, Grim Harvest is an excellent engine in almost any deck it can slot into. Shred Memory is how we're going to be able to run so few combo pieces but still have a chance to go infinite when games go long. Shred Memory also turns our deck into a toolbox, allowing us to go find all of the great one-offs I'm about to get into. If untapping our forests is going to generate the 10 mana necessary to loop our druids, we're going to want to make sure they make more than one mana each. Utopia Sprawl is the first way we're going to be ramping, and Gift of Paradise back it up while gaining us life after we've taken a couple of turns off building up our mana base. Finally, we have Fertile Ground as a tutor target for Shred Memory and Sakura Tribe Elder to go with our Grim Harvests. Our ideal turn one involves putting a Utopia Sprawl on a forest. If we can get a Gift of Paradise down the following turn, we've got enough mana to make turn three and onward super explosive. Running our whole handout to ramp is a surefire way to get hellbent. For this reason, I've included some cards to help us refill. Multani's Acolyte replaces itself when it enters the battlefield and is a serviceable beater in matchups where you've gotta go fast. Yavimaya Elder is next and keeps drawing us into our lands while allowing us to draw our deck while we're comboing off, so we are sure to find our win condition. Finally, instead of a third Elder, we have a Heart Warden as a tutorable way to draw our deck while we're comboing off if we've got a Shred Memory in hand instead of one of these creatures. We're interacting with our opponent in a few ways. Grazing Gladeheart represents a way to ensure we don't die to burn, and it's backed up by Consume Spirit that can get huge with all of our ramp spells or lethal when we've got infinite mana. Spore Frog joins these spells as a sort of pseudo life gain against creature decks. Once we've got the Fog Frog lock, there shouldn't be anything they're able to do. Removal is our other way to control the board, and it begins with Crypt Rats, our recurrable Wrath. Disfigure comes down earlier and ensures less ninja hits, while one copy of Doomblade and two copies of Chainer's Edict serve as even more tutor targets to remove our opponent's threats. Once we've had enough turns of locking down the board, we should be able to loop creatures with Grim Harvest until we find our combo pieces and win. We can also use the evasion on Swiftfoot Boots to peck in lethal in the sky if our opponent is getting constantly fog frogged on the ground. This isn't too bad for Plan B. For our mana base, we only have a few non-basics. First, Evolving Wilds and Terramorphic Expanse are our fetches to power up Gladeheart, and Bajuka Bog is our main deck graveyard hate if our Shred Memories are all transmuted. Alright, let's have a look at this sideboard. First, we have a singleton copy of Fester Creep as a tutorable way to deal with X1s, and two more copies of Crypt Rats to deal with the rest of our opponent's potentially larger creatures. We're running two copies of Thorn of the Black Rose to help us gain more card advantage than our control opponents. We have a Gleeful Sabotage as a silver bullet to tutor for against artifacts, a Moment's Peace as a silver bullet to tutor against Is It Blitz or Tireless Tribe. We have two Quiet Disrepairs as tutor targets in the burn matchup. We have a copy of Serene Heart, a tutor target against Boggles. We have three copies of Thermo Karst because our Tron matchup is terrible. We have a copy of Trace of Abundance to make sure our opponent can't target target our lands with their Denrova Horror, their Capsize, or their land destruction. And finally, we have a single copy of Nihil Spellbomb to make sure we can control our opponent's graveyards. And there you have it, Grim Memory. We're going to be taking this deck into a league at twitch.tv/anynewprovince this Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Atlantic time. We're there every Tuesday night playing possibly pauper playable decks. Before I go, I just want to remind you that you can like the video or subscribe to the channel down below. I'd seriously appreciate it. It's a great way to let me know you've enjoyed everything, and it really encourages me to keep making great pauper content. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this deck tech, and hopefully I'll see you on Tuesday night.